Amen. This morning, I want to talk to you in this text this morning. There's no need to fear. Jesus is here. Look at your neighbor. Is it neighbor?
Neighbor.
There's no need to fear.
There's no need to fear.
Jesus is here.
Jesus is here.
Come on and say it one more time. Neighbor.
Neighbor.
There's no need to fear.
There's no need to fear.
Jesus is here. Amen. Come on, bow your head this morning. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we do thank you this morning that you have blessed us once again to assemble ourselves. And Father, we just thank you, Lord, for your presence this morning. And Lord, we ask you this morning to breathe on this word. Saturate me, Lord, with your anointing for this set time. Bless the hearers and the doers of your said word. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Thank you, Lord. This morning, our thought is, there's no need to fear. Jesus is here. Look at your neighbor one more time. Say, there's no need to fear.
There's no need to fear.
Don't let you say it with feeling now. There's no need to fear.
There's no need to fear.
Jesus is here.
Jesus is here.
The text says, for God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. There's no need to fear. Jesus is here.
Amen.
I like to draw from the text and putting the text in context. We come to problems in our lives and the devil, your adversary, want to put fear where you got faith at.
Amen.
Matter of fact, if you walking by faith, he want to diminish the faith and put fear there.
Amen.
That you will not attain what you go after.
Yes.
The text says there's no need to fear. Jesus is here. I grew up and consequently all y'all came up in an age where cartoon was very prevalent. And it's something about them old cartoons, you would get up on Saturday morning, you would focus on it. And one of the cartoons would just get me, I would come up, little kid, little boy, and I would get up and I always wanted to like this particular cartoon. And one of the cartoons was Underdog. Because he was a crime fighter. This dog was a crime fighter. They even today made made it and put it in. I want to say it in a human respect. They made an Underdog in a human respect. They had a real dog. He went from a cartoon to a real dog. So Underdog was very popular. Even in my childhood days. Now I came up in my dark age that they made a movie called Underdog. And one of the slogans that they were saying when he would talk, he said, there's no need to fear. Underdog is here. People had confidence in that dog that he would come in and this. He was a crime fighter. He would take care of the situation. So I draw from that to my context. There's no need to fear. Jesus is here. There's no need to fear when you know Jesus is here. I wish you see what I'm saying. Because if you don't believe Jesus is going to move in your circumstance, you're going to walk around here in feet, undefeated. You're going to be defeated by what? Fear. You're going to be defeated by your mindset. You don't believe in Jesus. Because you got to first believe that Jesus got your solution to your problem. You got to have faith. Hebrews 11:1 said, now faith is a substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Amen? Now, First Timothy said, but God has not given us a spirit of fear. God never told you that you should fear anything. God never told you to be a man. He never told you to walk around with your head down when you get bills. The bill collector send you a pink slip and all of a sudden you go to worrying. He never gave it. It didn't come from God. Now if God didn't give you the spirit of fear, who did it come from? The devil. He's the author and the finisher of fear. That's why he points out, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, Woo! Good God Almighty, I thank God for Tim when he wrote this. He said, look, man, it never came from God. So who did it come from? The devil. But then when the Bible said that devil is what God gave it, but he God gave you the spirit of the power to resist the devil. He said, but power and of love and of a sound mind. You got to know where fear come from. In other words, there's no need to fear. Jesus is here. Uh-huh. There's no need to fear. For Jesus is here. And sometimes when you talk to people, they don't even have no concept of what you're saying. When you talk about God, being a faithful God, they look at you like you're crazy because they ain't got to that level. I'm talking to the people that got to that level that they believe God got their answer. I'm talking to church folk that believe in God. I'm not talking to the sinner because they're trying to get there. But you already should be there in your mindset. In other words, the battlefield of your mind, you should already have your mind so focused on God that you say, God got my answer. The devil is a lie.
Amen.
I will obtain what I go after. For the spirit of fear, it put me in what? Bondage. Bishop Jake was talking about how it is when you're in bondage. And Father, you got to cast down them thoughts of unbelief. Cast down those spirits that the devil told you, you ain't going to do nothing. You're going to be always on the low end. You got to cast down all those thoughts to tell you that you don't have it. You'll never amount to anything. Look at the enemy and say, devil, you lying. Whatever I go after, I will obtain it. You just one of the ones that been putting stuff in my mind. You got to cast down them thoughts. Amen?
Uh-huh.
Everything that comes up against the knowledge of law, you got to cast down a lot of them. You grow up and your parents told you would never be nothing. You ain't gonna never do nothing. But boy, you dropped out of high school, now look at you. You got babies all over town, you on drugs and everything, you never cast down all them thoughts. When people try to put poison in your mind, see, the people can be used of the devil. Anybody can be used of the devil. There's no perfect people. When your parents told you that you will always be in and out of prison, and boy, you ain't gonna never be nothing, and that girl that's got all them children and is walking around and is getting pregnant all the time, and you on drugs, and you need to cast them thoughts down. He said, greatest heat is in me. I'm gonna be somebody. When God came in my life, when I accepted God in my life, I'm gonna be somebody. Stop letting people beat up on you.
Yes.
With fear. Trying to put stuff in your mind. You walk around here with your head down because they done beat it on you. People can beat on you in your mind. You ain't got to take no whipping or no bell to beat you. They can beat you up with words. Words will beat you up. Words do hurt.
Yes.
They do hurt. And people talk to you down rich on your school and have teachers talk to you all kinds of crazy ways. Say, what you going to be? I don't believe you going to be nothing. They look at the children nowadays, they try to poison their mind. They make them feel like they ain't nothing. They try to put you in the low range thing in mind that you, that's a battle for the mind. You got to cast it down and say, I will be something. We had the movie up here, we had the illustrated sermon. It wasn't a movie. You don't move it. We got Super Flick up here. Spirit Flick up here. Amen? But this was an illustrated sermon. And Boomer, he got up there and he illustrated how Satan tried to come up against the children's mind. And said, you're not going to be nothing but you're the devil. See, the devil would tell you, man, let me tell you the truth. If you ain't careful, that's why you got to train the Bible says, train up a child in the way it should go. When he get old, he will not depart from it. See, let me tell you something. There's no need to fear. Jesus is here.
Amen.
But everything that the devil put in there, you got to put more word in there. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Every time, you see, he's a counterfeit. See, the devil's a counterfeit. Jesus is original.
Uh-huh.
Every time that the devil see that you're going forward, watch out, he got a counterfeit. Somebody's trying to stop you from making it to your destiny. You got to tell the devil he's a lie. My mama prayed for me, I'm praying for myself, the saints of God praying for me, and you trying to get in my mind. Get out of my head, devil. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. You got some power, but you got to speak with authority. You got to stop listening to that crazy stuff and hanging around people that do not give you what you need.
Amen.
See, you know what you need? You need more faith. Amen. You need somebody that every time they see you, they need to be pouring something. You can do it. You can do it. See, when people pour it into you and tell them that you're more than what you is now, I see greatness in you. Hang around people that's got your message, got your sermon. Say, I see greatness in you. I don't want to hang around somebody telling me that I never amount to anything. Hang